begin to do the greeting and the invocation. How beautiful are the feet of them which preach the gospel of peace.
Speak the gospel, Lord, and we will hear thy word.
Worship the Lord, ye his saints, shout unto God with the voice of triumph.
We will bless the Lord in his temple, and give unto him our sacrifice of praise.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
From the 118th Psalm, verses 14 through 29. Listen for the word of God. The Lord is my life. The Lord is my strength and my might. God has become my salvation. There are glad songs of victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. The Lord has punished me severely, but God did not give me over to death. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Save us. We beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you. Give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God and has given us light. Bind the festal procession with branches up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, I will extol you. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. For God's steadfast love endures forever. The word of God.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Now hear a scripture reading from the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, verses 1 through 6. I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that you walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called, with all lowliness and meekness,
suffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as you are called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all, and through all, and in you all. Amen.
For the reading of the Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, verses 14 through 19. And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. There went out his fame, and all of the region round about. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, as was his custom. He went into the synagogue on the Sabbath and stood up to read. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted and to preach deliverance to the captives and the recovering of the sight to the blind and to set at liberty those that are bruised and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." This is the word of the Lord.
And keep it.
Amen.
Herbert. We certify that she has been prayerfully examined and found fit to hold the office which she is about to enter. She has been duly elected to serve as presiding prelate by the National Board of Elders, and her election affirmed by the plenary of the House of the Lord Church. All matters pertaining to her elevation are hereby satisfied with the standards set with according to the doctrines, rules, laws, and traditions of the House of the Lord and Church on the Mount. She is properly prepared, qualified, ratified, and confirmed. We present her to you and the congregation, and ask that you lay hands upon her in the power of the Holy Spirit and consecrate her as bishop in the one holy universal apostolic church, and inaugurate her as presiding prelate of the House of the Lord Churches.
Let the testimonies be read. Responsibly perform the functions of the office of district minister. Now be it therefore resolved that the National Board of Elders approves the ordination of Leah Daniela Daughtry as district minister with assignments to Southeast District at the 82nd Annual General Convocation,
which is to be held in October of 2012. Be it therefore resolved that immediately following this ordination, Leah Diana Daughtry shall be appointed to serve as a member of the National Board of Elders, filling the seat reserved for the Southeast District Minister. In witness thereof, we hereunto set our hand and the seal of the church this 10th day of October in the year of our Lord, 2012, and in the founding of the church, the 82nd. Signed by Herbert D. Daughtry, Karen Smith Daughtry, Albert G. Miller, and Rinaldo Atkins.
The consent of the College of Bishops. We, the members of the Sacred College of Bishops, do hereby declare and consent that on Saturday, the 12th day of the 10th month, known to us as October, in the year of our Lord 2019, be elected and agreed to consecrate Leah Daniela Daughtry to be made a bishop in our Lord's church. The college gave unanimous consent in the Episcopal chambers on this morning during the induction to the episcopacy and the signing of the official documents. Witness our hands with the seal of the church in the name of our Lord this day. Certificate of Episcopal Consecration. By the grace of Almighty God, with an eye single to his glory, I, Herbert Daniel Daughtry, Sr., a bishop in our Lord's church and the national presiding prelate of the House of the Lord and Church on the Mount, did appoint Leah Daniela Daughtry to the Episcopal office of Bishop in our Lord's Church as a Bishop Ordinary and in by proclaiming her to the Church and the world as a suitable minister to the Holy Calling. And having been certified as one possessing holy orders, she was elected to the Sacred College of Bishops by the imposition of my hands and our hands, assisted by the Sacred College of Bishops of the Lord's Church, in a public service on the 12th day of October in the year of our Lord 2019 at the House of the Lord Church in Brooklyn, New York. We commend this servant to all the churches of Christ everywhere, ever praying God's blessings upon her labor. Witness our hands with the seal of the church done by the Most Reverend Herbert Daniel Daughtry, and with the consent of the co-consecrators, the Most Bishop Coletta Vaughn, the Most Reverend Jonathan Alvarado, the Archbishop E. Bernard Jordan, and the Most Reverend Eric Reynald Figueroa Sr., with the witnessing of members of the College of Bishops.
Christ our Lord. We're going to just endorse these documents and then we shall get right back to the program.
A synergistic work between the spirit and the people. The Lord calls, but the church makes bishops. A man or a woman is not a bishop in the Lord's church until the church adds their amen to what the Spirit has done. Calling is within God's purview alone. Elevation comes from those of us who have observed her work and have determined that she is indeed suitable for the work unto which the Lord
Amen.
Has called her. This means that you and I must participate. I'm working up on a nice way to say some of y'all are looking too much and singing and talking too little. In your ordinal, there is a section, and from this point on, there will be sections whereby you'll be asked questions. And I'm going to need more than seven people to say amen and answer the question. Brothers and sisters, you have heard testimony given that Leah and yet Daughtry has been duly and lawfully designated to be a bishop of the Lord, of the Church of God, and serve as presiding prelate in the house of the Lord Church is Young West London people. You've been assured of her suitability and know that the church has approved her for this sacred responsibility. Nevertheless, if any of you know any reason why we should not proceed, let this be made known now. Since there are no objections, you're good, but you're slow. I'm gonna work with you. Is it your will that we consecrate Leah a bishop? Will you uphold Leah as bishop? Will you rejoice in the fact that she will be used by God?
We will.
Will you encourage her in the exercise of her duties?
We will.
Will you support her by your prayers?
We will.
Will you assist her in the ministries to which she may call you as helpers?
We will.
I therefore charge you that you follow her with your prayers, that you assist her with your cooperation, and that you esteem her highly for his work's sake.
Thank you.
Let's give God a word of praise. Better praise than that. To have the privilege to do something I feel unworthy to do. It is my assignment and my task to introduce for the homily one of the greatest men that I've ever known in the person of the Reverend Dr. Herbert Daughtry. Reverend Herbert Daughtry is the national presiding prelate of the House of the Lord Churches, the third in succession. Reverend Daughtry hails from a family that has produced five generations of black church leaders. Currently national presiding minister of the House of the Lord Churches, he has previously served as the chairman of the National Black United Front, as well as founding and president the African People's Christian Organization. More than 50 years of involvement in church and community service has earned him the title the People's Pastor. Reverend Daughtry's long career began with the civil rights struggle in the 1950s, working with Brooklyn Core and Operation Breadbasket, and continues in the fight for community control of schools in the late 1960s. He subsequently helped to found several organizations, including Black Leadership, Commission on AIDS, Alonzo Daughtry Memorial Family Life Services, which serves the community through innovative programming, such as Families of Victims Against Crime, Against Violence, and Alonzo Daughtry Memorial Daycare Center, which provides early childhood education under the motto, nurturing and educating the leaders of tomorrow. He currently serves as the chair of the National Religious Leaders of African Ancestry, concerned about the fall. Can you say amen?
Amen.
There is a litany in his interview program, and this litany does not even scratch the surface of the exhaustive impact that the Reverend Dr. Herbert Daughtry has had on the world. A global voice.
Yes.
Talk back to me, somebody.
Yes.
And I am so honored to be connected to him, amen, and to stand in this holy place behind this sacred desk that has revolutionized, amen, the culture of Afrocentricity with the Pentecostal flavor. I can't get more happy than that. So at any minute, you may have to reach over and touch your neighbor. They all ain't saying nothing. That's black church, y'all. Reach over and touch your neighbor. Amen. Jump and shout and run and scream and dance. You can't do that everywhere. Can't get no help in here. Some churches you run and they'll try to catch you. Can you say amen? You fall out on the floor and they try to pick you up. You start crying and they try to bring you a tissue. When you go to black church, you fall on the floor, you stay there. You run, somebody will run with you. You cry, somebody will say, go ahead, girl. Let Jesus. I am so honored to have him and to have his precious daughter in our city and in our lives.
I'm going to close by this. A few years ago, not many, my daughter was kidnapped. She's standing right there, standing. She was in Buganda, in Africa. And they called from United Nations and they said that your daughter was kidnapped in Buganda. I didn't know what to do, so I did the only thing I could do. I called Reverend Daughtry. I had no association with Africa. It's about as close to Africa as I've been was 125th. And when they told me my daughter was kidnapped, I said, well, I'll sell the house and I'll steal all the church money. And I'll sell the church before the trustees find out anything. Because I'm gonna get my daughter. And I called Mary Daughtry, I said, Bishop, do you know anybody in Buganda? He said, oh no, you in trouble. He said, the leadership changes over there every 6 months. And the last leader didn't like me. But he called Congressman Ed Towns. And Ed Towns called me. And he walked into Hillary Clinton, Secretary of State's office. And 20 minutes later, Hillary Clinton called me on my cell phone. And she said, Bishop Figueroa, I spoke to Reverend Towns and Reverend Daughtry, and I want you to know, we're going to get your daughter. That's the value of knowing somebody that knows somebody that can do something for you you cannot do for yourself. Would you receive my daughter? When she finishes singing, will you rise to your feet to receive our homilies for today? Reverend Daughtry, Daughtry, National Presiding Minister of the House of the Lord. Would you give me?
To temptation. got to put on is to come on. And whenever he comes,
sensitive that it is time now to set aside the structure and let the Lord have his way. Now we are well prepared to follow the script. We have one of the greatest script writers in our midst, but we have several of them in our midst. One of them, of course, is the new bishop.
Amen.
But what you have just witnessed is a setting aside for a moment and let the Lord have his way. I am so glad, Anisha, that we delivered you from God. You are Amen. And Bishop, it's all family.
That's right.
I thank you for that introduction. I really don't know what to do. The introduction. I wish Johnny Green was here. He's a colleague of mine. And he used to say, when people would introduce him, or he had to follow an eloquent speaker, he would say, "Well, I feel like a donkey at the Kentucky Derby." We want to thank all of you who participate. By the way, I'm often asked, and obviously from your countenances I can see that you're asking, well, how do you feel? And I can tell by the solemn silence, you're still asking that question. Well, I don't know how. After all, I've never done this before.
Yeah.
I've never had a daughter to assume my place after 61 years.
Wow.
Wow. So if there's any psychologist, a psychiatrist out there, you tell me how to feel. I'm supposed to feel. And when I figure it all out, I'll let you know. But some things, one thing I feel, a sense of overwhelming joy and pride, gratitude. You know, and you parents readily understand, to have your children do well is a great source of gratitude. But then to have your children, all of them, make their own mark, put their own footprint on the sands of time, is unspeakably joyful. And Leah has been special. Just thank everybody for here. It would not have been complete without you. And while I am tempted to single out some people, I am so free.
Mm-hmm.
I'd leave somebody out.
Yeah.
And then I wouldn't be able to sleep for a week worrying about who I left out.
Right.
And some of you would be audacious enough to say to me, but you didn't call my name. So suffice it to say, welcome all of you. But especially, you know, I want to the call consecrators, Bishop Bernard Jordan.
Yes. He introduced me to the pastor.
Mr. Mignon in the back. And then Brazil, it's not unusual, she would be missing. And she in the back, I heard she isn't here.
Don't y'all tell her I said that. Listen, Donna came with me. We organized the National Black United Front. And they drove all the way from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, an old broken down car, to participate in 1980, June 1980. We were organizing the National Black United Front. So tell Donna Brazil that I just love her. And the Congressman, Yvette Clark. She's a member of the family. And Governor Dean, I guess he left. He was here earlier. But Governor Dean is special. And he was the chairman of the party, Democratic National Committee, when Leah was chief of staff. Well, she was chief of staff on a couple of them, Terry McCollum. And then he became president, the head of the National Democratic Convention. And at the same time, I was at the executive committee meeting in 2008, by the way, when they put forth the resolution that we want to say that Governor Dean and Reverend Leah Daughtry have put together the best Democratic convention this There was a second to the motion, and it was unanimously passed. So again, he's not here. He was here earlier. I'll always be grateful to him. And of course, I got family members, but especially to my grandsons here. They sang so beautifully my favorite song. I know a change gonna come. And to all of my children, as I said, they have made their mark on the pages of history. And you know, there's a certain person here, which I've been telling people, I was one of the best that have ever been on the basketball court. But you know, there's a story that Dave Dinkins used to tell, that there was a man who survived the Johnstown flood. And so when he got to heaven, he couldn't wait to tell his story. You know what I mean? And every time they were in heaven, people telling their stories, he couldn't wait, because he didn't tell people. He survived the Johnstown flood in Virginia. And so finally the angel said, man, be cool. Jonah's in the house. So because this president is in the house, I shall never anymore talk about my basketball exploit. Isaiah Thomas is in the house. The greatest I've ever done. So I again, and to all of my daughter-in-law, grandsons, everybody, I got nieces and nephews here. Now, it formed my life to try to gather myself together sufficiently to make some sense. Protocol dictate, honor requires, history demands that we say something that makes sense. And I was thinking, Leah, and pardon me, Bishop, and to all of the bishops, I was thinking of Luke, the 22nd chapter, and the 31st, 32nd verses. Now I can quote it for you, but if you just don't believe me, you need to read your Bible. You can take it out. But now, wait a minute, you got to make a deal with me. Once you take your Bible out and you read the verses, you put your Bible, close it up, put it away. try to read on while I'm trying to speak. People do that, you know. That's why I stopped giving out speeches before I speak, because they'd be reading a speech as well. And, but I'll try to quote it for you. With desire have I desired to eat this Passover with you. And then around the 31st, Jesus turns to Peter, and he said, Peter, Peter, the devil desires to have you, that he might sift you as wheat. But I prayed for you, that your faith fail not. And when you are converted, strengthen your brethren. And I just want to leave with my daughter, the bishop. Days of vicissitude, viciousness, and victory. There won't be days of vicissitude, changes, swift, dramatic changes. And there will be days in which people will be vicious.
Vicious.
Ah, Lord, but notice that. But I prayed for you, Jesus said. I can't save you from it.
Say hallelujah.
What you have set before you as your goal requires the price you have to pay.
Yes, Bishop.
My dear wife here, she can't get you there. And may I just say, they've given me credit for making a mark here and there, but whatever people give me credit for achieving could never have been done with the Reverend Dr. Karen Smith Daughtry. Special. Yeah, you've been, as I said, when I was lay dying, at least the doctor said, you know, Reverend, you may not be able to make this right, this operation. And what I said to you then, I said, well, girl, if I don't be able to make it, I loved you when I first saw you. And I'll love you to the day I die. And you are as beautiful and as brilliant as I first fetched her from her father's house. So I had to talk about that. The only problem talking about you, girl, is you just get me discombobulated. I don't know what I was doing.
Go ahead.
What was I saying? Oh, that's why you're my friend. There will be the changes coming before you. But let me talk. Let me see, I want to talk a little bit about Leah, who Leah is. And then I'll get back to the text. Y'all know how you do. You go far afield and come back. Leah was born August. No, I don't know how to tell the date. But let's just say I had to make a decision, monumental decision, around the time of her birth. Now my wife was kind of taking it easy, having a vacation. It was the time, what, 1963, what was happening? The march on Washington. And everybody was going to Washington. Buses were tuning up, and everybody, I mean, literally, the atmosphere vibrated. We were getting ready to go to Washington. Dr. King was going to be there. We got word that he was going to deliver a certain kind of speech. And
Roy Wilkins, Whitney Young's Urban, Evil Randolph, you know, Evil Randolph. And I must have put this whole thing together. And so we got it. And guess what? So I was telling Dick Gregory the story. I said, man, you know, Leah stopped me from going to Washington. I didn't go to Washington for the march. And he said, well, Reverend, he patted me on the back. He said, Reverend, don't feel bad about it. Because my son, I had a son, was born at the same time. And I went to Washington, and I haven't seen my son since. Dick Gregory was funny, that man was funny. Some people were funny without even trying to be. But it was comforting, I must confess. And so I brought her home. She nestled in my arms, about yay big. And I brought in my arms. And I named her. We said, what we gonna call her? I said, we're gonna name her Leah. That's a biblical name. And then we're going to name her after one of the great freedom fighters, Jomo Kenyatta, East Africa, Kikuyu tribe, connected to the Messiah warriors, never lost a battle. I just want to change, I hope Kenyatta doesn't mind, but I just want to put a D to it. But that, if you ever wonder what the middle name is, Leah Denyana, it's really Kenyatta. It's, and think of, go back and read your history of Jomo Kenyatta, the burning spear. Yes. So I brought her home, and Randy Weingarten, by the way, is here, one of our great friends. We rehearsed the years that we've been together, the National Teachers Association, and a host of other activities, but she would understand that I brought her home, Randy, Mom, when I hit the first step, I said, one, two, in her ear, three, four, five. And then when I got to the next landing, I shifted hands and said, A, B, C, D. And then we got her upstairs, and when they could wring her from my arms and put her in a little basket at the critical crib or something, I had the books. Bible was there, magazines was there. And I started singing, yes, Jesus loves me.
Hallelujah.
Mm. Now, let me stop this. They have lifted the standard so high with this singing. I marvel with these bishops who can sing. You know, I had a friend that said, you'll never make a preacher because you can't sing. John Lawrence, my mentor, great man of God, but he couldn't sing. I used to say, you can't sing, man. You'll never make it. But I brought her home, and from then on, we put pencils in her hand and books. I read to her, sang to her, and then it was off to school. Took her off to school, and it was my job to see that they got to school. Yeah, and it was my job. My wife, her job, we just assumed the role. But once they were brought home, she would do a lot of the teaching and what takes place at the home. But I would make sure they got to school. That was mine. And I told them later on, don't worry about what how you treat it. I'll deal with the system. You deal with the books. So we took her off to school. And she went with a little pencil and bag. And they wanted to put her, Randy, in the doll corner, you know, the kitchen. So she looked at that, and she looking for, you know, where you read and write. And no, the teacher said, no, you got to go in here. And she said, I'm not looking. So I realized even then we had another Daughtry resistor. And she didn't. She wouldn't go. I used to go up to that school every day. The principal was Mr. Weingarten. Every time he see me come out, and so finally, well, why don't you just give her a test? That's all. And they did. They gave her a reading test, and she just entered school, and she was reading on the third grade. And he said, "Oh man, this is marvelous. Put it on the third." I said, "No, that's too much now," because she was just a tiny something. I said, "Just one grade, this would be all right. Just one grade." So she was skipped one grade, and later they put her in the school for gifted children. And then in the early years, I would take her to the UN, and we'd sit at the UN. I wanted her to see people of African ancestry and power. You know, our communities, we see so much that negative, but in this world body, yeah. I wanted her to see men, women of African ancestry, yes, moving, yes, with authority, moving, yes, with power, yes, that would help shape her worldview.
See that?
And she taught her the names of African leaders, and she would sit one person in particular, never will forget. I couldn't pronounce his name for the world. Alan Bishop. I couldn't get it. Still can't get it right. And so finally, she must have been about 5 or 6 or so, she looked up and said, Daddy, it's Marlon Bishop. Marlon Bishop. Marlon Bishop. And I knew then that, you know, I was always going to be listening to Leah and was always going to be her servant. That whatever Leah said, it's fine. Maybe I should have known then that she was going to finally be the bishop. But we took time when I was trying to learn Greek, you know, New Testament Greek. And I would take her with me and her brother with me. And everything I'd learn, I'd try to teach her. So I'd try to teach her Greek, the Greek alphabet, Greek alphabet. And she learned it before me. Yeah, she started teaching me the alphabet and probably still know it, and I don't. She went off to Dartmouth. We got in touch with Carl Call. I wish he was here. It's him. But Carl and I have been great friends. And I said, well, my school, my daughters are getting ready for college. I said to them, listen, I don't care what school you go to. But, you know, some people say, well, I got to go to the black college. I said, listen, I'll teach you all the blackness one another and all the African women, but you pick the best schools in the country. You go to the schools where the presidents go, and when you come out of those schools, you will know that you have the mental capacity to compete with anybody in the whole world. So she chose Dartmouth, and we got in touch with Carl McCall, and she ended up in Dartmouth. And then finally, it was the practice, you know, of you educators to send the children off to various countries for a semester. And she picked France. And, well, I had to accompany her. So we spent 2 weeks. It was my practice to go spend time beforehand. She went to Paris, and we spent 2 weeks together up and down the avenues and sipping coffee in the outside veranda and visiting the library, and then she had to go off to rural, a little village there. The only problem was I had to leave her.
Leave her?
Wow.
Yeah. And when I got back home, I think it was 2 weeks before I could open my mouth. You know, and then finally when I could say something, I said, well, I'm going back. Because I left her on the a lonely waif there, I thought. But she was just as happy as she could be. And I'm tears coming down my face. And she's grinning all over the place. And the couple that she was there with, you know, what shall I say? They weren't the same color as me. And I didn't know how to take that. But she was happy. And we left her there, and she did her semester in France. And then finally, when it was time for her to seek employment, it so happened that I knew Congressman Ed Towns. And I called him and said, listen, we got a brilliant daughter. Why don't you need an intern? And he said yes, and so she went to work for Ed Towns. And then the colored girls took over. And I guess that was all right. And so she has been the epitome of scholarship. One of the best organizers I know, and I think I'm pretty good at it. But most of all, she has not caused her any trouble at all.
See that?
Yeah, none of the children. I told my children that, listen, if you want to end my life early, you don't have to do any, just ruin your life, mess up your life. And I don't shorten my wife and I years. And they never did. So I never went to the Brooklyn Bridge. And so again, Leah, to this day, we thank you.
Thank you.
And let me hasten to say, nobody elected her. Let's not, well, take some praise, if you please. But really, she was born for what we have done here today.
Amen. Yeah.
And that's one of the reasons why I counted the history. Just in case there may be somebody who says that she's here because her father was before. And No. She brings all the qualifications necessary. She brings the spirit of her ancestors to the occasion. She represents the fifth generation. Mother Rob was a freedom fighter on the plantation, slave fighter. He was, you know, Malcolm's differences about slaves. But her great-great-grandfather was out in the fields fighting enslavement. Her grandfather, William Van, was presiding over in Savannah, Georgia. And then her dad was the founder, I'm not granddad, the founder of this church. And then I happened to be come along and here I am. And so she's the fifth generation. It runs in the family. Yeah. My dad said to me, even when I was going through the valley, that boy's my preacher. He's the preacher of the family. And it was the joke of the family, because everybody knew what I was doing. I was a long way from being a preacher. But he held on fast. You know, he's the preacher, baby boy, he's the preacher. And here I am, or here I was. And so Leah was born. I felt it. That's one of the reasons that she was trained from birth with all that I knew. Was available to her. And so
God bless you, Leah.
Yes.
But I just wanted, the reason why I read the scripture is that it was it's a kind of solemn occasion. It was the feast of the Passover, and it was Jesus' last supper.
Yeah.
And they gathered around the table, or just sitting around. They didn't have forks and knives, you know, it was with your hands. And after a while, Jesus said, "One of you going to betray me?" And the questions which came was kind of interesting of how well we know ourselves. Because they began to ask, "Is it me? Is it not one?" And Jesus said, "We know who the one. So please now, I've allowed you to stay among us, but time has come for you to leave. You don't always try to kill the devil, because sometimes you try to get rid of the devil and a whole lot of angels will follow. So you sometimes have to let the betrayers alone for a while."
See that?
And then he turned to Peter, his favorite. And you got to remember that Peter, all along the way, was up and down.
Yes.
And on occasion, Jesus said to him, "Who do you have people out there say that I am?" Yes. People said, "Well, are you Elijah, you're one of the prophets." And Jesus said, "Well, what do you think?" And it was this Peter who stood up and said, "Well, it's you're the Christ, the Son of the living God."
And Jesus said, "Well, flesh and blood didn't reveal this to you, so you're special." Now there's some theological debate as to what Jesus meant. Some said that he was really giving Peter the keys to the kingdom, you remember. Whatsoever you bow,
whatever.
And but others say it wasn't so much the man as it was the person. But be that as it may. Point was, he was kind of special. This really guy, he's a person. In fact, Jesus called him because many really were sinners. And Jesus called him because he's good for a pebble or a rock. And now we come to the last day. And Jesus turns to him and he says, no other disciple, all the rest of the disciples, and you special. But I want you to know something. The devil wants you.
And
sift you like me. Now, Vince, you know, it's interesting that he identified people. Because there was something about him that had specifically called for what he was going to do.
Yes.
And for all of us, keep in mind that when we are called for a high purpose, there is a bullseye on our back.
Yes. True, Bishop.
We become targeted by the forces of hell. Yes. They don't bother, maybe they didn't bother who was in the manual. We don't even remember who he was. What was the name of the other disciple? We don't remember who he was.
But Peter was special. And therefore he was targeted. And what Jesus was saying is that you've been targeted.
Yes. Targeted.
By the forces of hell. They're coming after you. And you know, I don't know how you feel, but I guess if it were me, Jesus would say, "Herod, listen, the devil coming after you, man, he's coming after you." And I said, "Yeah, well, what you going to do?" And Jesus said, "Well, I'm going to pray for you.
Pray.
Is that all you find? Is that all you going to do? Pray." But they told me you had special power, you know. Coming out of humanistic field, you know, immediately I would say, "Come on, Jesus. Throw some blows. Come on."
I didn't know how to throw a few blows, but you're Jesus.
Jesus.
Yeah, you're the miracle. So I pray, I stood, but need the prayers in the closet. I fight for them. Put the legs on the prayers. But what Jesus is saying to us, I will be marked as well. Be careful of the goals that you set for yourself.
Yes, yes.
Because they come with price tag. I'm sure Isaiah didn't get to be the Hall of Famer, didn't get to be the great basketball player he was, because he decided on the playground that I want to be a basketball player, and then went back home and went to sleep.
Right.
Went back home and got on the computers and watched the stories.
Right.
My dad said that he got into the gym.
Yeah.
And day and after day and night, yeah, while others were playing and whatever. So it comes with a price tag.
Yeah.
You want to achieve something high, you got to pay for it. That which we gain too cheaply, we esteem too lightly. And so Jesus is saying, I can't break the law for you, Peter. You're all right, you're special, I like you. I must say, you're my favorite, but I can't break the law for you.
Can't do it.
You got to go through.
Got to.
My body will be broken. And tears will come to my eyes. But I can't intercede in the way you want me to intercede. You got to go through. But the victory. The victory is, I prayed, and I know how to get a prayer through.
I know how to get one through.
Yeah, I know how to get one through. And therefore, I can say with authority, when you have gone through, when you have paid the price, when you have borne the whips and scorns of time and the slings and the arrows of outrageous fortune and the thousand natural shocks that the flesh is hit, you're going through and you have the victory.
You have
the victory just to get a shout in the camp. We're not going to have the victory just to lift our hands and say, let's praise the Lord. No, you're going to have the victory and you're going to do all of that. Yes, you're going to dance the victory. You're going to raise your hand the victory. You're going to sing the song
of the victory. You're going to have testimonies of victory. Yes, but you're going to do more than that. Strengthen those around you.
Strengthen.
You're being strengthened. And you being encouraged to go through the fire, not just for your own satisfaction, but that you might become a savior. You're being saved to be a savior.
You're going through the vicissitudes. You're going through the viciousness, because victory will be yours. But the victory is not just for you. The victory is not for your joy. The victory is not to pat yourself on the back. The victory is meaningful because it means victory for somebody else. God calls us not for ourselves alone, but for others. If you are saved, you are saved to be a savior. If you are blessed, you are blessed to be a blesser, so to speak. God takes us through. I don't know who's here. Let me raise your hand for a moment. How many of y'all feel, I know Randy, but been through the fire furnace. Raise your hand. Been challenged on every side.
Been through the fire. Take heart. Be encouraged. Because if the enemy has targeted you, you must be somebody special.
Don't get discouraged.
Don't get discouraged.
Don't get dejected. Don't get despondent. That's why Jesus said, blessed are you when they shall revile you and speak all manner of evil against you and persecute you. Rejoice! For so persecuted the prophets who were before you. In other words, Jesus was saying, you're in good company. If you're striving to make a difference in the world, you're in good company. Think of Gandhi. Think of Dr. Martin Luther King. Think of
President Kennedy. Think of the great men and women who tried to make a difference in the world. They were targeted.
Targeted.
So you're in good company. That's why James said, rejoice. Count it all joy when you're being tested on every side. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
So Leah, I want to say to you, as a father, the days will come. And I want to, as it heats up for you. And the thing about it is, sometimes you don't know where it's coming from.
Where it's coming from,
Bishop. Yeah. And you'll be tried and tested. And Daddy will want to grab you in his arms and hold you and dry your tears.
Yeah.
And pat you on the back as Daddy used to do.
Yeah.
It's going to be all right. Daddy's going to be there to fight for you. Don't. But Daddy won't be there.
Yeah.
Daddy will be there, but Daddy ain't going to say, but you got to go through.
Got to.
Yeah, you got to take it. I can't get in your way. You got to take it, but I'm gonna pray for you. I think I can get a prayer through.
I know you can.
And I'm gonna pray for you that when the day comes, that even around you, you don't know who's for you and who's against you. When the day comes that they begin to say all kind of manner of evil things against you. Ah, Lord, when the day comes that you feel nobody loves you, remember you are special.
Special.
You are targeted because you are special. And I and Mama and Bishop Figueroa and all of the bishops, then you can just read what the word says. We are all going to be praying for you.
Yes.
That your faith fail not.
And
when you go strong. Think of the world. You think you have accomplished something now? Oh, but the world awaits. God's going to do great things. Oh, Lord, let the church
pray.
Oh, God's going to do great things. And this is why I have to get off. You know, I've been at it a long time, 61 years. I had some good battles. But I was a different kind of servant. I was one of them troublemaker, you know, one of them radical revolutionaries, loud mouth. I think they used to call us militant in those days, long time ago. Yeah, I would make everybody angry. I was angry. Everybody ought to be angry. Everybody ought to have a fighting spirit. And so I might have alienated people all over the place. But thank God, I've got a lot of friends too.
Yeah.
But I'm it's a different kind of minister. Bishop, you said something to the effect that our time is now.
Yes.
Something like that.
Yeah.
But the times change.
Times change.
Thank God for the sisters.
Yes.
Church, amen.
Yes.
Thank God for the women.
And
particularly the remembrance of African ancestry. Wasn't it now? I think it's 75% of you black women vote in the Democratic Party or something like that. Wow.
75% of black women are registered to vote.
75% black women registered to vote. Isn't that something? The world changed. I don't belong here. You belong here. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
So as David passes on to Solomon, and I ain't in the, you know, the corruption part of that. But the time has come for me to step aside.
Bless you, Bishop.
And I conclude where I left off. How do I feel?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm about to
step aside, and one of my children,
yes,
one of our children,
Lord Jesus,
is going to take over, and not just take over, but prepared for it from her birth. God has prepared you from your birth. We didn't make you. God made you. We didn't set you up. God set you up. You were simply just doing the protocol stuff here. The joy of, in the morning, I'll wake up for the first time in 61 years. First time in 61 years, I'll wake up and I won't have a national responsibility as far as the church is concerned. And then when I wake up and realize I don't have national responsibilities, and after I get myself together, I'll say, oh, but Lee is the bishop. Let me go back to see him. She was in charge almost from the day she arrived. She's been teaching me and leading me and advising me and taking charge of me from the day that she arrived, and now she can take charge of the church.
Yes! Yes!
She's in charge. You in charge. God bless you all. Remember how many I have made the changes. However many the vicissitudes, however much the viciousness, whatever come your way, remember you got the victory. Victory is certain. You hold the winning hand. You're going to make the last shot, the bell ring, but you're going to make the last shot. You're on your way, child. You're on your way. And all I've got to say is I've taught you from the beginning, all of you from the beginning. What is the family covenant? Love God, love the people, put God first, work with and for the people.
Yes.
And God will bless every generation that comes along.
Hallelujah!
Transition, you will strengthen him. There are books in him that haven't been written. Let generations sing songs about Herbert Daughtry. Take us back to our ancestral connection and help us to reach the next generation, that they will remember the life and the legacy of your servant. Thank you for him. We thank you for him. We praise you for him. That we were born to allow our paths to cross. And because every step he has taken is a step that brings us closer to destiny. Thank you, Lord, for your servant. Keep his body well. Keep his mind strong. Keep his
his heart fixed in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for relieving him of the burden of the national work. We bless you right now. Make these days his best days, his greatest days, his richest days. And we will not forget that he has brought us this far by faith. In Jesus' name, amen. If you believe God has heard that prayer, just before we lift the offering, amen, one of Bishop Leah's special guests is here to bless us with the gift of his voice.
Say amen. A voice that has been heard across the world. Would you receive B.B. Lyman?
No, come on, Brooklyn.
You may be seated. I just want to give honor where honor is due, and now I understand, Bishop Leah, where you get it from. From your father. As he was speaking, I thought about my father. I thought about my father, and it's just a blessing to come from a household where mom and dad teaches you not only the things that you are, but also teaches you about who God is. Yes. And so I honor you on today. I give thanks also, Bishop, to Brother Clarence Williams. He was indeed not only giving you $10, but he was giving me and my family $10. When we started out, it was Bishop Clarence Williams who fed us and clothed us. He did so much, so we honor him. Amen, amen, amen. I've just come to encourage my sister. She told me I had a choice in song, but I know I didn't have a choice in song. And so I am glad to be here just to tell you that not only the color girls, but there's a color boy that's on your side. And then God will give you the strength. When the enemy comes, he's already prepared a way of escape. So we bless you on today.
Yeah.
you've given your all and seems like you can make it through. Well, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord, watch Him bring you through. After you've done all you can, you just stand.
Thank you. you're gonna stand. Oh. Let's give B.B. Winans a real big hand. Come on, y'all. Thank you. This is a beautiful, just turn around and tell somebody, this is a beautiful occasion. You didn't tell nobody, tell somebody on the other side. This is a beautiful occasion. Let's try to raise $10,000 right quick so we can help the new bishop. Can you say amen? I don't care how much bishop you are. You can't be but so much bishop without no money. Can you say amen? I ain't got no help in the building. I want to thank God. I'm going to give $500 this afternoon. Clap for me. Yeah. If you leave now, it will cost you $500. Don't even go to the bathroom, hold it. I'm going to give $500 and I'm gonna try to challenge at least 9 others of you to do the same. Reverend Al Sharpton, he wasn't able to be here today, but he just sent $500. Why you're not clapping now? That's a blessing. Can you say amen? Amen. All right, and so Dr. Eugene Rivers sent $500. Let's say amen. That's 3 of us. There should be 7 more of us that just come real, real quick. Can you say amen? I need somebody to come up here that can count. Can you say amen? Bishop Daughtry said he took Leah up the Bishop Leah up the stairs and he said 1, 2, 3, 4, say amen. And so I'm glad that I don't know when she got into algebra, geometry, or trigonometry. Amen. But it starts with 1, 2, 3, 4. Can you say amen? All right. Who else can sow that seed today? Amen. Would you come quickly? Myself, Pastor Rivers. Amen. Al Sharpton. Who else? Family member? Friend? Amen. Color girl? Color guys? Thank you. You can make checks payable to the house of the Lord. Say amen. Amen. Thank you. Here's another one. Amen. Oh, okay. Sister Weingard. Amen. $500. Let's say amen. Thank you. Oh, you gonna help me? Okay. I know you can count. Can you say amen? That's 4 of us. Thank you. I know you're coming. Thank you, my dear. Karen Finney, $500. Give her a hand. Come on now. That's 5 of us. I need 5 more of you to come quickly. I need 5 more of you to come quickly. Can you say amen? Do you love Leah? Say amen. Love is what love does. Thank you, amen. Sister-in-law, amen. And brother is, oh no, that's Sister Moore, I'm sorry. That's colored girl, is that a family friend? Who is it? Don't make me no difference, it's $500, can you say amen?
Working it out now.
Amen. Thank you, Bishop. Amen. Bishop Coretta Brown, Coretta Vaughn is giving $500. Let's say amen. Who else? All right. Let's say amen. Oh, my God. Say amen. Give electronically to my right if you we have that capacity. All right, that's good. All right, come here. This is Georgia, right? Sweet Georgia. All right, I know she's sweet because she just said the Holy Ghost told her to give $1,000. Why you not talking? That's why nobody will ever give you nothing. Clap your hand. Go get it. Send one of the young people over and get it and tell them to come right back. Can you say amen? It's all the way over. All right. I'll go get it. It's not too far from me. Can you say amen? All right. Amen. Who else have that $500? I need about 4 more of you to come. Here's one. Amen. Come on. Electronic. Come on. Right over here to my right. Those of you. And
we don't carry checkbooks.
Bishop Jordan is on the line. Let's, Archbishop, I know you got to give us an impartation today. Thank God for Bishop Bernard Jordan. And look at these color girls. Can you say amen? I don't care what color you are. Go on, get on the line. Come here, Brother Isaiah. Thank God for Brother Isaiah Thomas. Let's give him a hand. Get a picture. Post it everywhere. Would you like to say something to your sister? I know how, you know.
I just want to say I love you and thank you.
Come on, give him a hand. And I want you to know. I want you to know. That time you got your eye cut, you wanted to come back. That thing hurt my feelings, man. That thing hurt my feelings, man. I know, listen, he made it out all right. Look at somebody say he made it out all right. He's giving $5,000 anonymously today. Give him a hand. Give him a hand. Now, don't y'all try to get no money from him on the way out, because I know it's not for rent. Can you say amen? It's not a rent party. Say amen. It's not a rent party. Not tonight. Excuse me. I want to thank God for Archbishop Bernard Jordan. Amen. Upstage with me, he's giving $1,000 today. Why y'all not clapping? Let's celebrate giving, because love is what love does. There are others on that line. Amen. And we don't want to. We took time with the dancing. We took time with the singing. And took time with the preaching. Now you want to rush the offering. No, I'm not going to do that. Amen. Ask me why. I want you to be blessed.
Amen.
It's not a hustle. It's not a trick. It's not a game. If you give, God will give it back. Good measure pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Can the church say amen? When your seed leaves your hand, it doesn't leave your life. It goes into your future to bring you a harvest. Can you say amen? Anybody else with that $500? The house of the Lord, Bergen County, $1,000. Why y'all not? That must be them up there. Give them a hand. We are all going to meet in Bergen County at the end of the month to share with Pastor Dawn in her Sweet 16. Can you say amen? Why y'all not clapping? We want to fill whatever place that is. We want to overflow it. We want to overrun it. Because she too is one of the gifts to the body of Christ. Let's celebrate Pastor Dawn. Daughtry. Who else? Who else? Come. Hey, Mom. Yes, Mom. Okay, they said, tell that that the house of the Lord 415 is giving $1,000 to. Now holla now. She said, now holla now. Come on, write that. Are you writing that out? Write it all down. Amen. Who else? House of the Lord, someplace else?
God has blessed us.
Yes.
And we want to give $500.
Beautiful. Let's say amen. Come on now.
Oberlin, Ohio.
Oberlin, give Oberlin a hand. All right. Look, Oberlin, is there anybody else who wants to sow? Amen. This is a good time to sow, house of the Lord. Amen. You know, the new bishop is a politician. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. She's a politician. Amen. And so you may need to bring your discretionary funds now. Use your discretion and bring your funds. Can you say amen? Say amen. Maybe you didn't have 500. I would ask you if this is all right, but you almost not the presiding bishop no more, so. You're not looking at me because you want me to stop, are you? Okay, all right. Amen. Because you said the new bishop is in charge. You said that. She got me out of here. God bless Bishop Daughtry. Is he something else? Wouldn't you love to have a grandfather like that? Let me see your hands. And you would love to have a grandfather like that. Just somebody to sit down and talk to you. Keep you, amen, grounded and balanced through, amen, the vicissitudes and the viciousness until you get your victory. Say amen. Anybody else who has that love gift? Perhaps you have $300. Oh, here's another hand. Come on. Perhaps you have $300 and you want to bring it to help Pastor, amen, to help Bishop Leah now. Thank you. Yes, credit card. How much you giving?
In behalf of Jersey City Church, we're giving
$500. Jersey City Church, give him a hand. Oh, that's your brother? All right. Okay, that's my neighbor. Amen. She used to be my neighbor. She sold in the house and got a lot of money. Can you say amen? Amen. Me and my wife, I have a brownstone. I have several brownstones. Me and my wife, we lived, she was our neighbor across the street. Me and my wife was about to break up. We were arguing and fighting about 10 years ago. Vicissitudes. And I told her, I'll sell this house. They went, man wanted to give me $1.5 million for it. I said, I'll give you half of it if you'll just come to church and act right.
Act like we still together. Shout when I preach, and I'll give you half this money. Amen. I said, what you think about that? She said, no. Mm-mm. I said, oh.
She said, you don't want to leave me? She said, no, it's not that. She said, I'm just going to wait till you die and get it on. Look at somebody say, smart woman. She said, you can go someplace if you want to, but when you get there, tell her.
You ain't got nothing. I bet that'll change the way she feels about you. Everybody with $200, if you have $200, would you bring it now? Would you bring it now? Amen. Everybody, every family member, come on. Every family member, every well-wisher, amen. Everybody that want to be on the new bishop's council, come now. Thank God. You want a national office, come now.
You owe any money, tell them, bring it now. Thank you. I need 50
people that will give $100. 50 people, you got that. Thank you, son. They're waving their hands all over. Come this way. Come this way. Come on. I need 50 people that will give $100. Would you come? Amen. Would you come? Thank you, daughter. I love you. Come on, everybody. Everybody, everybody, thank you, doctor. Come on, everybody. Thank you. Isn't this beautiful?
Amen.
Isn't this beautiful?
Amen.
Amen. Don't shake your head. It's not court. Say amen.
Amen. Amen. I told you this is an Afrocentric Pentecostal church. You got to say amen. When I say amen, you say amen.
Amen. It's called call and response. Amen. It's called call and response. Thank you. Thank you, my friend. Thank you. I love you. This is beautiful.
Bless you, mother. You looking mighty good. Can you say amen? Give her a hand.
If you're giving electronically, you may give to my right. Thank you so much. We have to get out. I know, Bishop. I know how you are. I know how you are. Can you say amen?
Amen.
And I want to come back next time. I want to preach for the convention, so I don't want to wear my welcome out. Can you say amen? All right. Everybody with $50, would you come now? Would you come? You can give $50.
You have not given. Would you rest on your feet? Would you rest? Now, if you don't have your money, then that's why you sit down. Wave your hand. Let me see you. Lift your hand up and just put it in the pocketbook as close as you can. Come this way, everybody, with the best gift that you can. Come on. Makes no difference what the Father has.
I can call it.
don't want to take it too long.
Yes, I have this blessed assurance. I can call it. Exceeded the goal. Can you say amen? Would you rest on your feet? All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own as we give. All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own as we give to thee. Everybody say, ah. Give God praise, everybody. Thank you.
Come on, let's give Bishop Figueroa a great big hand. Let's just thank you. Get back to the program. Some people have to leave, and I just want to recognize them before they depart. I don't know. Carlos Jesse was from around here. He's the person who engineered all of this, orchestrated everything. I want to recognize Star Jones is in the house. I don't know what happened. Carlos, Bishop Carlos Jesse, who's the engineer.
Here we go.
Bishop? He engineered all of this. He takes care of this. Anybody want to be a bishop, you see Carlos Jesse. Yeah, he Bishop John, Carlos Jesse, man, he make you want to be a bishop when he get finished. So let's give him a great big hand.
My sister Leah, God has chosen you and we have appointed you while the people have affirmed their trust in you by proclaiming your appointment. A bishop in God's Holy Church is called to be one with the apostles in proclaiming Christ's resurrection, interpreting the gospel, and testifying to Christ's sovereignty as Lord of lords and King of kings.
You were called to guard the faith, unity, and discipline of the church, to
to celebrate and provide for the administration of the sacraments of the new covenant, to ordain elders and deacons, and to join in ordaining fellow bishops, and to be in all things a faithful and wholesome example for the entire flock of Christ. With your sisters and brother bishops, you will share in the leadership of the church throughout the world. Your heritage is the faith of the patriarchs, the matriarchs, the prophets, the apostles and martyrs, and those of every generation who have looked to God in hope. Your joy will be to follow him who came, not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many, in order that we may know your mind and purpose, and that you may be strengthened in your resolve to fulfill your ministry. We ask you to give witness to these things.
Are you persuaded that God has called you to the office of bishop in his church? Will you accept this call and fulfill this trust in obedience to Christ?
I will obey Christ and serve in his name.
Do you accept the Holy Scriptures as uniquely revealing the work of God and containing all things necessary for eternal salvation through faith in Jesus Christ? Will you be faithful in prayer, Bishop, and in the study of the Holy Scriptures, and to such studies as to deepen your faith and increase your love, reverence, and service to God?
I will, for God is my help.
Will you boldly proclaim and interpret the gospel of Christ, enlightening the minds and stirring up the conscience of your people?
I will, in the power of the Spirit.
Will you guard faith, unity, and discipline of the church?
I will, for the love of God.
Will you be faithful in ordaining and commissioning those whom you believe God has called? Will you constantly guide, support, and encourage them and all others who minister in the church?
I will, by the help of God.
Will you strive to fashion your own life and that of your family and household according to the way of Christ, so that you may be a wholesome example to the people?
I will, by the help of God.
As a chief pastor and priest, will you encourage and support all baptized people in their gifts and ministries, and nourish them from the riches of God's grace? Will you pray for them without ceasing, and then celebrate with them the sacraments of our redemption?
I will, in the name of Christ, the shepherd and bishop.
Will you be merciful to all? Will you show compassion to the poor and strangers? Will you defend those who have no helper?
I will, for the sake of Christ.
Will you, by precept and example, lead the people of God to participate in the life of the community, in their obedience to the mission in the world, and to seek peace, justice, and freedom for all people?
I will, by the help of God.
May the one who has given you the will to do these things now give you the grace to perform it, that the work which God has begun in you may be brought to fulfillment. Faithful is God who calls you, and faithful is He who will never fail you.
Through these promises, you have committed yourself to God to serve His church in the office of a bishop. We therefore call upon you, chosen to be a guardian of the church's faith, to lead us in confession of that faith.
We believe in one God.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day He rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom shall have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father.
Thank you.
Therefore, God, make Leah a bit
in your church.
Dwell upon her the same
spirit. Yes.
Whom he bestowed upon the beloved Jesus of the earth. With whom he endowed to be a apostle. And by whom your church is built up in every place. The glory and the unceasing praise of your name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
For jewelry or for decoration, but it represents the chains of a prison. For we are prisoners of the Lord Jesus Christ. Paul wrote his chain with pride, that I am counted worthy to suffer affliction for the gospel's sake. Let us adorn the bishop now with the ring. The ring is a token of covenant between the bishop and God. It is based upon the scripture concerning the prodigal son. It demonstrates favor upon the person who is wearing it. It is worn on the right hand, and it is the primary symbol of the office of the episcopacy. Now there are the symbols that will be offered at this time. The National Board of Elders will present the canons of the church.
The oil is now presented with the following saying.
Use this oil and be among us as a healer and reconciler.
Representatives of the worship and arts now present the hymnal singing.
Streets. that the people might worship, receive these keys, and be among us to keep our church doors open for all people.
That are standing with thee.
Mm. Yes, Lord.
And there are generations that have prayed for your day to come. It was no accident where I placed you and how I have assigned thee. Know, saith the Lord, you have walked in these doors one way, but you will leave out of these doors another way. A mighty voice shall I make thee. So now prepare yourself to pick up this mantle from your father and your mother.
Yes.
For they have shown you the way. Now you begin to do the way. You'll be known as the way maker.
Thank you, God.
You'll be known as the way maker. And you will make ways for people and pull them through the doors, and your life shall be known. The name Daughtry shall never leave the earth.
Thank you.
Thank you, God.
Thank you.
And what you will do for women in this next decade is going to cause a new force of liberation to come forth. So the Spirit.
Which has made me overseer to assume the office of
as I envisioned, with all the sacredness and sublimity, to plead and stimulate the people of God by your life and examples, as well as your pattern of preaching and preaching, holding fast the divine command and vision for the church which was given to you by God Almighty, to admonish and exhort the people of the house of the Lord and Church on the Mount, Incorporated, to spiritual growth and personal development, more effective witnessing of Christ, and the building of Christ, and the building of His kingdom, to provide pastoral care and direction to pastors, fellow servants, and Christian workers, ministering grace and support to those in need, to submit yourself to the Lord with all prayerful humility, and by your example, teaching those under your charge, and to do the same, knowing he or she who is greatest among you must be the servant.
I accept this awesome responsibility and pledge with all due diligence my unwavering commitment to passionately pursue the purpose of Christ and God's kingdom in general for the house of the Lord and Church on the Mount. I will, by the grace and power of the Almighty,
yes, Lord.
Thank you from the family to the Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh. Now, Lord, we will answer. Hallelujah.
Koshtamais.
Your hands upon the neck. Join me.
Yes.
Set us aside.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
To lead this great church.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus Christ, our Lord's name.
I, Herbert, Chief Consecrator, according to the authority of this, that the Lord God created our brother Jesus Christ, the head of the church, and the officers and members of the house of the Lord and the Church of the Lord, present Leah, bishop in our Lord's church, and national presiding bishop of the house of the Lord church.
Thank you.
I've never been one following scripture instructed to teach. But you know, I just feel, daughter.
Family, I love y'all so much. Oh my goodness. I'm grateful to this group of co-consecrators who stepped forward to give me their blessing. I love you. Eric R. Figueroa, who would call me, nobody like him.
Nobody.
Who would call me and say, how you doing? What you need? He made phone calls, and I would check and say, did you call so-and-so? He said, now you know you gave me an assignment. And I always fulfill my assignment, and so I'm grateful to him and who he has been in our lives. And Bishop Vaughn, y'all know I couldn't do this without a female bishop.
Absolutely.
For her, the ministry that she has, the Lord has given to her with the place that she is, my friend Jonathan Alvarado. I adore him. He's in Atlanta, Georgia, doing a work all across the country. He's going to take me to the gun range and teach me how to shoot. I'm looking forward to that. Yes, and to the Archbishop.
Yes.
Prophet E. Bernard Jordan. He is the master prophet. And the word of the Lord is in his mouth.
Yes.
So we honor him. And so grateful that you would join us today. Of course, Carlos Jesse, son of God. He knows how to move and put all these pieces together. And they told me, you know, Leah, you can't run this. Because I'm the one that usually does this. And they said, you just have to sit down. And you know it was killing me.
I was like, really? But he said, Carlos will be there. He'll make sure. And I was like, okay. It took me all the way to last night.
That's you.
And
we are grateful to him for all of the gifts and the talents that he has given to us. There are so many people I see that are the streams of my life, and I'm so grateful to you all for being here. It would not be the same without you. And of course, head of the list is my girls, the Color Girls.
Yeah.
And Yolanda, where's Tina? She Catholic, so you know. It's too long for her. This is too long for her. She, you know, she 45 minutes an hour. She did good though, because she was here at 9 o'clock. So we thank God for everything.
Just being my girls. Through good, bad, thick, thin, we've been together 30 years.
Beautiful.
It's, they are joys to my life. And all of my Daughtry people. Daughtry friends are here from New Hampshire, Vermont, and all the different streams. That's my college roommate. From freshman year,
40 years ago. And we still friends. Yes, Marsha Trent. We had a third roommate, but we don't know where she is. I think I might have been the first black person she ever met. She walked in that room and I had Malcolm on the wall. And Beth was like, okay, what's this gonna be? Hi!
Because you know mommy had us there first when we moved into college. Her plan was you had to be the first one in the room so you could get the good bed and the good mattress. She would go up and down the hall finding a good mattress. And so by the time your roommates got there, you were set up. They had to work around you. That was her, that was Marsha. Marsha walked in and said, okay, great, I am Marsha. Those are my very dear friends, and I'm so glad that they made the travel. My children are here. I got a lot of children. Not by birth, but by oaths. And I want y'all to stay. All of my children. And this is my newest daughter. She joined me about 3 months ago. She came from God to be with us today. Well, I didn't hear that. She came from God. Love you all. The original children in the back. Amen. And I want to say to you and to all the others, it's time to come home. We call it all the sons and the daughters of the house. It's time to come home. Y'all ain't saying amen.
Amen.
It's time to come home, daughter.
Come home.
It's time to come home, son. It's time to come home. Y'all not clapping? It's time to come home. Y'all have done all y'all. It's time to come home. We need you.
Yes.
We need you. Is that all right?
That's all right.
Don't act like you never heard it. Heard it first. It's time to come home. The doors are open. All roads lead.
Amen.
Thank God for my friends and politics and making the world better. Congresswoman, but I was doing good till Bobby got up. I was having a straight face with Congresswoman Bobby Watson. Stepped forward and I lost it. And she and the Congresswoman Yvette Clark have been some of my good pals and buddies up on Capitol Hill, and we're grateful to you. And my sister, Randy Weinberg.
Yes,
the president of the American Federation of Teachers, 1.7 million members strong.
Yes.
And I'm going to share this story. She's not just a labor union leader for me. Some years ago, I was struggling, I was unemployed. I couldn't buy a job in the farm industry. We can talk about that later. I'm just saying. And I was on my last set of money. And my sister asked me to go with her on a teacher trip to London and Paris. And I spent my last money traveling with my baby sister. And I said, now how am I gonna pay my mortgage? How am I gonna pay my bills? And sitting in a hotel room in London, Randy Weingarten called me. And she said, I have a task for you. And I said, well, what is it? She said, well, we have to go to West Virginia. I said, West Virginia? What am I gonna do? What you doing in West Virginia? He goes from Brooklyn, West Virginia. So she said, well, when you get back, come with me on this trip to West Virginia. And I did. That was 7 years ago. She didn't know it, but she saved my life.
Wow.
Jesus.
Wow.
The Lord used her to save my life so I could pay my bills. But more than that, gave me a work in Appalachia where I never would have gone. And in the time that we have worked there, the partnership we have built there, we have increased graduation rates by 20 points. We have reduced teen pregnancy. We have dentists and doctors. We have banks. And a place for hopelessness and violence. And last month, we broke ground on the first new housing in McDowell County, West Virginia in 50 years.
Wow.
So when you talk about the gospel, when you
about what ministry is. Yeah. Yes, it's in the four walls, and we can run it. Like, we Pentecostal, we've been here how long? We don't mind. But it is the work in McDowell County, West Virginia, yes. Bringing people health care, yes. That they don't have, yes. Housing that they don't have, feeding them because they don't have, yes. Ensuring the basic needs. That's what Jesus commanded us to do. And I have been privileged to, because of the work that she gave me at a time when I needed the work, it became more than work. It was ministry. It was ministry, and I'm so grateful. We've been here 7 years. We got a few more to go. I'm grateful to you, Randy, because you saved my life. And I'm grateful to you because you gave me a path to do ministry in a place I never would have gone. Never would have been in the heart of Appalachia, and I'm grateful to you for allowing the Lord to use you in that way.
Amen.
Of course, I got to shout out my mom. To help me celebrate, to lift me up, to surround me with love. I'm so grateful. Yes. I'm so grateful. And last but not least, the house of the Lord. Trusting me,
for agreeing to stand by my side, for being excited,
for agreeing to take on the work.
I adore you, and I'm going to do the best I can do to lead us into the place God has called us, and designed for us before the foundation of time. I'm grateful for each one of you, each one of you, each one of us. God has big things for us on the horizon. The harvest is ripe, and we are ready. Yes. We're going into the vineyard, picking the grapes, the cotton, whatever it is, and carrying some nets. We're ready.
Yes,
I believe we're y'all not ready.
Yeah.
But I don't pay a lot of money for this reception. So we gonna dismiss quickly so y'all can go eat and I won't be mad because there's a whole lot of food left over. Hey, man, we're going to...
Beautiful view. We have a bus that can take people if you need transportation. We'll run a loop and we'll move off of there. We're grateful. We're grateful for each one. And I hate to start calling names because then I'm going to mess up and I'm going to leave somebody out. Somebody's going to be mad. But Sister Star, I love you. Brother Isaiah, I love you. Amen. I love you. And then very special, here's my mommy over there. She went downstairs. Mignon's mom is my other mom.
Amen.
And as Mignon said, she started getting ready about 4 months ago, picking out her outfit. So when y'all see her, she is the best ever, beside my own mommy. So we're grateful for her. So let's go to this litany, and then we can go eat. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Amen. 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 Thank you, Leslie Callahan, for coming from Philadelphia.
Amen.
I love you. And I wanted Leslie because she's a strong preacher and she knows how to read the gospel. She just celebrated her 10th anniversary as pastor of St. Paul's Baptist Church. She was the first woman pastor at that church. She's doing her work there. But she's also immigrated from McDowell County. She's from McDowell County, from Gary, West Virginia. So we're going to take her down there on one of those trips. So that's the other reason I wanted her, because when I see her, I think about how much I love West Virginia. So there are different gifts. There are different ways of serving God.
But it's the same God who achieves his purpose through all of them.
Each one is given a gift by the Spirit.
To use it for the common good.
Together we are the body of Christ.
And individually members of him.
Though we have different gifts, together we are a ministry of reconciliation.
Led by the risen Christ, we work and pray to make his church useful in the world.
We call men and women to faith, so that in the end, every knee shall bow,
and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And now unto him who is able to keep us from falling,
yes,
and to present us without spot or wrinkle, faultless, before his glorious presence with overwhelming, exceeding joy.